Cool, so our next step is to download and install Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to go in the browser, in the Chrome browser, in the address bar, which is more or less in the same array as Internet Explorer, and I'm gonna type download Visual Studio. And by the way, it's not just Visual Studio, so it has to be Visual Studio Code. So don't miss the code part, okay? So code, C-O-D-E. Okay, so I'm going to go for this on HTTPS Visual Studio Code download. Okay, so I'm clicking on it, and then as far as I can see, we got Windows, Linux, and Mac. So I'm just gonna click this one, the Windows one, the big button, and wait a second, and it started to download it. And then once it's done, I'm going to click on the file, which is going to open the setup for me. And the very first thing, I'm going to accept the agreement. I'm not gonna read it because nobody reads it. And if you can read it, or if, well, you can read it, but if you read it, drop a comment in the section below and let us know, why do you read it? Because it's unusual. So next install. Visual Studio Code is an editor that allows us to type code into it. So to type words, characters, and so on, in a way that it's easier for us to code the website. So it saves us time in different ways. Cool. So we also see this checkbox, which I'm going to leave it checked. Launch Visual Studio Code. And once it's launched, you're gonna see Visual Studio Code. Cool. Almost. It also opened another web page. So I'm gonna close this web page. And this is Visual Studio Code over here. This blue icon. Okay, so I can move the window. This is the window of Visual Studio Code. Before I do anything, I want to do the same as I did for Google Chrome, which is right click and select pin to taskbar. Yes, because we are going to use it a lot. And then I'm gonna hold my left mouse down on the icon, and I'm going to start dragging it up, and I'm going to move it below or beneath the Google Chrome icon. Now we could leave it as is, however, I have a preference and I do not like all the time dark themes. But maybe later on we can chat about it. Maybe you do like dark themes. I like light themes.
I like them.
So I'm going to go here at the file menu and I'm going to the preferences section. And in the preferences section, I'm gonna look for something that says theme. Okay, I found color theme. Also, it also has a shortcut, Control KT, right? So let's remember that shortcut if we can. If not, we can directly click here, color theme. Once we click on color theme, we can use the up and down arrow you have on your keyboard. Four arrows, one is up, down, one is up, one is down, one is left, one is right. So find those keys and use up and down arrows. So as you use up and down arrow, you can see that the theme beneath changes. And I'm going to look for a lighter one. So yeah, I like this one. I don't think there is a difference between Light Visual Studio and Light Plus. I'm gonna just choose Light Plus and go on with it. Now I'm going to maximize this window for a second, the Visual Studio Code. And I'm also, well, I think I'm gonna leave it as is for the moment, right? I think it's enough. I just close the welcome. And we need one more thing to do, right? Which is to download Git. So download Git. Okay, so what I'm looking for is this website, gitscm.com downloads.
And what is Git?
So Git is a software that allows us to easily hold a history of our progress within the project. And most importantly, it allows us to collaborate with different other people, like other coders or, well, other people like managers and so on. So it's a tool that relieves you of many possible headaches by making your life easier when you're developing websites. So again, I'm going to go for the Windows version and I'm going to click the download button. And then once it is downloaded, I'm going to click this file over here, which is going to launch the setup for Git for Windows. And again, it's a next. And over here in the editor, if you do have the Visual Studio Code setup, I'm going to choose use Visual Studio Code as Git default, as Git's default editor. Now, if you don't do this, don't worry. It's just a preference. So just click next until you're done with it. And once you're done with it, we can further continue to do our necessary steps or the next steps to build our website. Cool, we're almost there. So I'm going to uncheck this box which says view release notes. I don't care about release notes. However, I am going to check this box which says launch Git Bash. If you did not check that box and you click finished, which is going to open this Git Bash over here. If you did not check that, that's okay. All you have to do is press the start key and type Git, and you can find Git Bash over here. So you can open Git Bash like that, which is one and the same. What I'm going to do right now is to right click this window over here for Git Bash. It has an icon with a blue, red, green, and yellow inside the rotated square. So I'm going to right click it and select pin to taskbar again. Then I'm going to hold my mouse down, the left mouse, and I'm going to start dragging it up underneath Visual Studio Code. So now I have Google Chrome, Visual Studio Code, and Git Bash. And for Git Bash, I want to type something in it. Firstly, I'm gonna make the window bigger, and then I'm gonna hit Control Plus a few times for you to see easier on the screen. And what I'm going to type is node -v. So node -v or node --v, whatever rocks your boat. So if we are going to type that and we get v12.6.0, it means Node.js has been installed. Yes?
Yeah. First line is the computer.
Yeah, it's the computer. Yeah.
Okay.
And this one over here that I'm selecting, it's a tilde, it's called a tilde. And whenever you see this tilde, it means a place where what's called in this computer the user's home place. So wherever it's your user home, my user home, and so on. Right? So that tilde is like a shortcut to the home of the user or to the user's home. So when we typed node -v, we asked the node for its version. So -v means give me the version. Sometimes -v works and sometimes -v doesn't work. And when -v doesn't work, sometimes --- or --- version works. So with any given program that we are going to use in the future, try one or the other until you find one that works. What we also want to do is git -v and unknown option -v, but it also told us git also told us something, which means git is working. However, let's try git --version, and we can see that git version is 2.22.0 Windows whatever. So now we confirm that node is working and also git. And now I'm not sure if Visual Studio Code can be done in the same way, but let's try it. So let's type COD, like code, -v. Well, it did work. We have 1.36.1. So yeah, it's working. Let's also do code version. Well, it works with -v or --version. It just works. So now we confirmed in the console, in the Git Bash console, that we installed Node.js, we installed Git, and also we installed Visual Studio Code. It's just a way for you to confirm that some software is present or not. With that said, let's see each other in the next lesson when we'll start actually to build the website.
Listen.
Bye.
Bye.